That's what it was all about, a chance to go to Wembley and compete in the FA Cup final. We were at Villa Park, so many facts and figures surrounding this game that I could throw out. You like, for instance, that Alex Ferguson had never lost an FA Cup semi-final, like United had never lost a semi-final at Villa Park. Arsenal had only lost one in nine attempts here at Villa Park against Manchester United, ironically, back in 1983. But let's keep it simple. We got the top two teams in the country on collision course, and it really did promise to take your breath away. Let's check the team news. Manchester United left out Paul Scholes and played Nicky Butt in the centre of their midfield. Ronnie Johnson continuing in the absence of the injured Henning Berg. Cole and York together up front. No Manu Petit for Arsenal, of course, suspended. Vivas got the nod in midfield alongside Patrick Vieira. Anelka and Bergkamp together up front. Don't take your eyes off it. Here it comes again, Andy Gray and Martin Tyler.
So here we go, the favourites for the FA Cup against the holders, the Premiership leaders against the defending champions and closest challengers. Both these clubs are awash with honours and chasing each other for more silverware. And a lot of repair work at Villa Park after the Premiership game here yesterday. Get the pitch in reasonable order. Villa Park, where Manchester United have never lost an FA Cup semi-final, where Arsenal have lost just one to United 16 years ago. First clearance from Tony Adams. And then Martin Keown's header. David Ellery, the referee, sure to keep an eagle eye on the early challenges. That was Butt and Parler.
Well, normally I would say, here we go, Martin, semi-final, first few minutes. Hearing them, scare them. I don't think we get that with these two. I think they're so experienced now. They have so much respect for each other. They know each other pretty well. I think they'll just try and slip it in what they would regard as normal for the routine in a football match.
Anelka. Bergkamp, who missed the semi-final last season when Arsenal won on this ground against Wolves. He was suspended there. Dixon. Vieira. Nigel Winterburn, who's really defied medical diagnosis to take part today. A challenge by Gary Neville on Overmars.
Very tight, wasn't he? I think the one thing I watched United play on Wednesday, Martin, they didn't start the game in the kind of tempo. I thought they were, that's a booking. There's no doubt in my mind. That's silly. There should be more experience than that, Gary. Going away with a tackle from behind seconds earlier, where he did probably just win the ball, but nowhere near it. Yeah, absolutely nowhere near it. Could have no arguments. He's now going to play 88 minutes against Mark Overmars' pace and not miss time another tackle.
The psychological early edge for Arsenal. And the free kick to follow. Well, any sort of touch there.
Great ball in. Horrible to deal with. And when it misses the front post area, where two have gone in, it just needs anyone getting in the end of it. Through Vieira's legs, we'll think that was a chance, the Frenchman. Drops down quickly over the heads of the ones at the front post, but any touch at all from Vieira would surely have tested Peter Schmeichel.
Overmars. Anelka rather running into his space. Overmars trying to carry the ball. The grass on this pitch does mask a rather uneven playing surface, and there's more work for David Ellery here. He's got the card out, I think, for Vivas.
It is, Martin. Yeah, just a little off the ball. As David Beckham pops the pass away, you see the block from Vivas. Deliberate. No arguments. Two silly bookings we've had in the opening 6 minutes of the match.
Oh, that's a push. On Keown. That's how the referee saw it.
And I see Dwight York just asked a question. There was a little bit of contact from both. It looked a pretty good battle, you know, the edge of the 18-yard box.
Nothing out at
2 for Ray Parlour at the moment. He does, when he does tuck infield like that, then it does allow Dixon an option to come forward. Mark, he's trying to pick him out twice now. Parlour hasn't connected with him yet.
Here's Giggs. Good for Winterburn. Don't want to panic. Not letting it run for Bergkamp and looking to speed up the return.
Brilliant
the danger, very well recognised by the captain.
Yeah, that was a classic counter-attack from Arsenal. Ball into Bergkamp and then Elka spun in it. He did what I thought he'd do, he left Johnson, but the captain was aware of it.
It's United's turn here. Giggs, the orchestrator of this attack. Andy Cole on the ball. Adams only partially away. Chance for Keane to have a crack. His first touch was a bit on the heavy side. And now Arsenal. A very bright beginning here. No semi-final tension so far. Bergkamp unlucky. And who was chasing up for the pass? Tony Adams. Parlour, Arsenal have got it again. Keeping United on the back foot. Anelka, past Irwin, but not past that.
Oh, what an opening to a semi-final, Mark. I thought we might get a bit of respect, a little bit of sparring, a little bit of fencing. But they've just come out and gone for it, particularly Arsenal, who, well, what a start. Let's hope it continues like this.
Vivas. Well read this time by Gary Neville. Beckham. Arsenal made a mess of trying to get that away, and Neville loops him across. And Giggs and Cole confuse each other for a moment. Cole has it. Giggs has a great chance. Oh, a terrific chance for Manchester United.
Oh, what a chance, Ryan Giggs, and he knows it. Well, they really commit, almost commit suicide here defensively, but once Martin Keown misses it, then both players, Keown and Dixon, are attracted to the ball. Vieira thinks to join them. It leaves Giggs absolutely wide open. It's perhaps a little bit square to him. He had to take half a step back away from goal.
Adams.
Good battle in there. That central midfield, yeah, but Keane Vivas.
Bergkamp. Better movement from Arsenal this time, including Parlour and Dennis Irwin. Just got enough of the ball there to spare United's blushes.
Well, the defence has been fantastic, Mark, so far in this match, and it's had to be because of the attacking football and the build-up has been superb at times, and both sets of defenders are really having to be at their very, very best to stop any chances being created. Super interception from Dennis Irwin.
Vivas through the corner. Oh, it's Adams! Who has scored the winning goal in an FA Cup semi-final in the past against Tottenham at Wembley.
Well, Stam gets caught under it. He's responsible for Adams. He's never really beaten the goalkeeper. It's straight at him. I think Tony Adams will feel this was a chance for him. He doesn't really get up and get it powered, he just directs it using the pace on the ball.
Now towards Keown this time. Played by Giggs. Bergkamp. He's a bit slow to react there. Say that about Cole, but the free kick given against him. Dixon. Bergkamp wanted a free kick, didn't get it. It's a clip ball to York from Giggs. Dixon with the interception.
And you just think Dennis Bergkamp, above all others, would want to win this match, Mark. Missed out in the final last year. He has talked about it, his disappointment in that happening. You just feel that he, above all other Arsenal players probably playing today, the more determined of any to make sure his team get through.
Okay. Some variety into Manchester United's positional play by cropping up there. Anelka, not really controlled. Beckham on the wander again. Blocked by Keown with Watt. Decision is a corner. Manchester United fans have a part of the big Holding stand. The majority with Arsenal behind that goal, but the United contingent had a good look at this.
Yeah, it's in the arm, but I don't think he had anything to do with it. The corner's a right decision. And we're looking for better delivery than his last one.
Well, just over half an hour play. Plenty of invention. No goals yet. First FA Cup semi-final today. Giggs. There's a deflection on it, but it suited David Seaman in the end. Winterburn moving more freely now. Vivas. Roll there to ease it wide to Dixon. Manchester United well, they're grouped up defensively, and Arsenal can't pick a pass through them that time. Giggs. They just seem to carry on the pace beyond where Andy Cole wanted the ball to drop. The outlet for Arsenal through the right back. Bergkamp. Manchester United a little slow to react. Overmars waving at Winterburn outside him so that he could go on Mark Overmars with that change of pace. And what a vital tackle for Gary Neville. If he got it wrong, it would have been a penalty. It probably would have been a sending off for him, having been booked.
Well, this is why we're 0-0, and this is why hardly any keepers had a shot to save Martin, because the quality of the defending has been absolutely top draw. Again, perfectly timed tackle from Gary Neville.
Tarling's coming in. Beckham, beaten up by Schmeichel. Ray Parlour's there. And it's Irwin who clears, as he was mown down by Adams, who apologises for the foul, which the referee spotted.
What a save, though. What a save. Time was brilliant about this. You look at the way he gets past players here, Martin. He's on his line, but look at him. By the time the shot comes in, he's 6 yards out. And had he not gone there, then Vieira just might have stuck it, a right foot out and knocked it in.
Bergkamp, has he got the acceleration back? Came keen again. With a sense of responsibility, he's always had that as a player in terms of the strategy of his football, not always in terms of his temperament, although captaining Manchester United has curbed a great deal of the previous successes.
He's done that brilliantly in the first half. Roy Keane been very important.
Beckham just got a yard on Winterburn here. Now, is it going to be one of the great Beckham crosses? Dixon gets his head to it, drops for Keane. Opportunity for Gary Neville to whip it in now for Manchester United. Off Martin Keown's head, another Manchester United corner.
Well, you'd always expect, I think, Adams and Keown have positioned right, and the ball's tossed in there to win it. It's got to be more Beckham-like the cross, you know, a bit of pace, bit of bend. Gives York and Cole a better chance.
By Beckham. Giggs chasing his own touch round Dixon. Great play by Ryan Giggs, and it leads to a chance for Roy Keane, but the flag is up, it's not going to count.
I'll tell you what, Martin, that's one to debate. That's one to debate. I don't see how you can give offside here unless somebody's offside with a cross, and they can't be offside with a cross. Oh, he's offside there. I tell you what, the flag's gone up early, I think. Now it's gone up again. Now this flag's gone up when Ryan Giggs tucked it round the corner. It's not for the shot, it's nothing to do with that. That will be debated, and long and hard. I think it's a goal. I think it should stand. I think the linesman's got it wrong.
Well, David Ellery may not have made his final decision yet. He's pointing across to the far side, Graham Atkins, the linesman, and the referee has accepted that point of view from his assistant.
Watch this, Martin, now, as he tucks it round the defender here. Now look right in the middle here, just the 18-yard line. Now the flag's gone up. It comes down again, you'll see, but as soon as Giggs crosses, the flag goes up again, because there's nothing wrong with this goal. I think it should stand.
An easy back pass for Schmeichel to deal with, although he made it look easy with a bumping volley.
Well, it's been a good half of football. We haven't had goals, admittedly, but I tell you what, there's been much to admire in this game so far.
Were signalled for the time to be added on. Vieira. Arsenal have settled the quicker of the two sides, there's no doubt about that, but Manchester United have picked up their game as the half has developed. York rather reflecting their current confidence with the back here. Giggs. And number seven tricking the other. Vivas getting the better of Beckham. Vivas wanting to take it on. David Ellery thought there was an advantage there. I don't really think there was. But it spares him having to make maybe a more awkward decision. Good challenge by York. Benefits Cole. Back for Dwight York. Oh, and he couldn't really dig out a shot.
No, I think he should take it on his left
to survive again.
I think he should take this out his feet on his left and hit it. I think by trying to control it on his right, it gives Keown enough chance, makes the shot awkward. Whereas if you take it out onto your left side, even if it's not your strongest, just hit the thing. You can get power, you can hit the target, you can really test the keeper.
9 years here at Villa Park, Dwight York. Taken plenty of chances, more difficult than that one on this ground. Well, a lot of good attacking play, some fine defending, and one great debate here after 45 minutes of this FA Cup semi-final. Those arguments still going on about the disallowed goal. This is what it was all about. A case of when the flag goes up. Seemed to be that the first point, I think you just see it at the top of your screen. So what happened after that, in the mind of the assistant, was academic. It was a rasping shot, took a deflection on the way in from Roy Keane. United thought that they had scored, the shake of the head from David Ellery. I don't think we've heard the last of this one. But at half-time at Villa Park, it's Manchester United 0, Arsenal 0. Well, I should imagine Alec Ferguson was at the head of a lengthy queue asking for clarification at half-time from the officials about the disallowed goal. Arsenal must have thought for a moment that they were behind, something that's not happened to them in any game since the third round of the FA Cup when they were two down at Preston.
I think that's right. That would have been an interesting little 15 minutes in the dressing room area at half-time there.
Get the second half underway. They got down to business quickly here at Villa Park, but then came up to half-time, arguably the best 20-minute spell that Manchester United have had against Arsenal maybe in the last couple of years.
Yeah, I think it was a stage in the match where sometimes you don't want half-time as a manager, and I don't think Alex Ferguson would have wanted half-time. I think Alex would have been quite happy for the game to have carried on. His team had weathered, not the storm, but they'd got themselves in the game. They were the dominant factor just before half-time. And that little lull would have allowed Arsene Wenger to get his team in and just put one or two things straight.
A disallowed goal, plus those two chances, Giggs, before it happened. And Dwight York right on the stroke of half-time. Here is York, supported by Key. Neville. He forced it past the Winter, but it's a great cross. Andy Cole couldn't quite turn it in. Giggs looked to turn it back. And Manchester United looking to pick up here where they left off at half-time.
What a ball from Neville. Just drops it in over Keown's head. I tell you, they get lucky again, Arsenal. Lee Dixon really didn't know an awful lot about that. Just hit him as Giggs tried to turn it back. What a chance for Cole.
Play for Keane. Giggs. Beckham. Keaton Beckham. Very crucial figures for Manchester United as they picked up their game midway through the first half. Nicky Butt doing his expected battling bit in midfield. Sticky start to the second half for Arsenal. Argentinian Vivas working overtime here into the back line, the midfield man today.
Well, he had to just for a minute. David Beckham got in behind him, but Vivas was able to spot him and get back in.
One throw from Gary Neville. Giggs. Referee shakes his head again.
Flags up again, Martin, just below me here. Don't think the referee's seen it, he has now. Just went up as Ryan Giggs was just hooking the ball over his head. Drops down the edge of box, and as Arsenal come out, you can see two United players. Flag went straight up.
Snap. It's a throw that David Ellery has given. United have got no right back at the moment. Gary Neville's crossing from the left. Now can Arsenal get the ball to Overmars here?
They've got decent protection. Well, Nicky Butt very quickly spots that.
Beckham. Giggs. Cole. There's no flag. Andy Cole for Manchester United. And David Seaman was able to make the save. Cole would have preferred it on his right-hand side, I'm sure.
Well, there was evidence of a weaker left side. That's a glorious opportunity.
Anelka. Can Arsenal find the goal touch? Only a few seconds after they were looking vulnerable again. The clearer chances in this semi-final had gone to Manchester United, who contentiously had a first-half goal disallowed. Bergkamp.
I don't think the check was ever on. Got a little bit narrow, a little bit tight. Thought he may have taken the hit early as the ball just got played down. They work it really well for once, and I thought just as it's in front and one touch and hit. Took two touches on it, got a bit narrow. But Andy Cole's at the other end was a really good chance, Martin. Tony Adams steps out to play offside. Well, you can't do that when you're centre-back and is opposite you and playing him on, and that wasn't a great strike.
Parlour. He's got a bit in to spare there because a bit in hand. He's the right man to play against the Anelka.
Well, he gave himself a little depth there, gave himself a 2-3 yard start.
Arsenal were 2-0 down, as we said earlier, to Preston, came through 4-2. They won at Wolves, although the team was sent off in their Sheffield United saga. Expert comments from Steve Bruce. And then the quarter-final against Derby, which, you know, the villain, I think Sheffield United, the villain here is Vieira for Arsenal. York, it's Dwight York with three in the centre. Keane, who was complaining he was being held as he came in, it went straight at Seaman.
Well, I might well have been doing, but Lee Dixon, if you're a defender, It's exactly what you'd have wanted him to have been doing, Martin. He was all over Roy Keane. But Vieira's a lucky boy. Really sloppy play for him.
Anelka over Mars. And that's the free kick. No.
Well, that looked a free kick to me, I have to say, Martin.
And to me. York. Whether the referee's view is masked as Overmars went down. Keane. Neville. Inside the last 15 minutes, and that's of course we go to extra time. Cole. From Beckham, Andy Cole got in front of Martin Keown there. Here's Parlour trying to impose himself through midfield, surrounded by players in red shirts, but helped by Vivas, Bergkamp. This is Lee Dixon. Well, Bergkamp. Onside, corner for Arsenal. Crafty pass by Dixon.
There's nothing else on here, just lack of movement, Lee Dixon, Mark. He was looking around and both Anelka and Bergkamp were just kind of standing, not offering anything. He actually made them go after it with the deftness of his pass.
Vivas with the corner. Easy for York.
Well, Roy Keane's come very close as anyone, is scoring a goal today. Look at his run into the box, brilliant, but watch Lee Dixon. He was saying, okay, I'm not getting there, but I'm going to make it difficult. And that's exactly what he did. He made it awkward for him, but look at Keane fighting for the header. Lovely play.
Gary Neville, three in the centre for United, and Neville couldn't pick any of them out.
What a chance, Martin.
There was Cole, there was York, there was Giggs.
I think Andy Cole's prime place here. We break him here, and Andy Cole's just going to find himself at the edge of the six-yard box. You see him, he wants it. Anything fed along there would have given Cole a brilliant chance. But once again, it's Manchester United who are fashioning the chances, who look the most likely. That's always a dangerous thing to say when you're playing against a side like Arsenal.
Keown. Oh, somehow guiding it on to Anelka. Manchester United in the shape of Butt. Have put so much into this 80 minutes. You sense that a gap or two might open up before we reach the 90-minute mark. Play on, says David Ellery. Giggs lets it run, and it's come all the way to Butt. Beckham went over the leg of Overmars.
Well, this is a chance, is it, a foul? David Beckham looks to tuck in. There's a little bit of contact made, it's a free kick, it's obstruction as much as anything really there, but the arm's not going up. David Beckham will know he's in a situation here where, well, a goal now with less than 10 minutes to go might well be the match winner. We do have the option, Giggs of course, equally as good, might suit the left footer.
Beckham scored in his last two league games, for a long time without a goal. Trying to mix things up a bit. It's Beckham! Well, David Seaman moved very late, and had it been on target, one would have feared for Arsenal.
Well, if the wall's doing its job, then it's... And this is coming wide of the wall, you expect it to be wide of the goal. You see the way he's hitting it, it's going to be swerving from right to left. It might start on target, it's only a yard wide,
but this swerve was always going to take it that way. Was it Dixon there who was pretty grateful to get out of the way?
I think if he'd have driven it, David, and hit it that straight mark, that might well have gone in off the post.
Michael's penalty area, it won't. It's on the roof of the stand. A massive kick.
I won't be getting that back. Not for a while.
Well, it's a massive contest. As predicted. It wasn't a difficult call, was it? But one wonders what would have happened if that Manchester United goal had been allowed to stand in the first half. But he's kicked by Dixon and he got lucky. Vieira. A roughhouse treatment on Anelka by Jaap Stam.
I think they've played them really well, Stam and Johnson. Bergkamp and Anelka played them really well, the defenders.
Overmars. See what was in his mind. Man who had a famous late winner against Manchester United at Old Trafford last season. And tilted that fascinating Premiership race Arsenal's way. Carlo was a bit late there. And David Ellery says that's going to be a booking.
A little unlucky, Ray Parlin is at full speed and Dennis Irwin just tries to nick it over him and away, and I don't think we can have any arguments about that.
Yes, it was the height of the contact, yeah. But made up the referee's mind. Dennis Irwin, who usually for Manchester United player, knows what it's like to be in a losing semi-final team. It was against Manchester United for Oldham back in 1990. If you can't beat them, join them. Philip Neville on duty as a cover, maybe. Was used in the quarter-final as a man marker in the original game on Gianfranco Zola. One wondered perhaps in the build-up to this one whether Bergkamp might have been singled out for that sort of treatment. Well, that's sad for Dennis Irwin.
What's the checking
one out?
Yeah, the decision to be made that quickly, Mark. It's been tight second half. One or two opportunities, but you know, neither of the goalkeepers has had to do anything special.
Here's Anelka. Has he shaken off Stam? Oh, Wembley was beckoning for Arsenal there.
Cooler head, a little bit more craft and talent he might have been in. This is the first time. It's a great run and a great ball. Absolutely perfect for him, Anelka.
Beckham, 90th minute at Villa Park. Gary Neville's ball in again, and Keon seemed to lose his balance, and in doing so, interfere with Andy Cole.
Yeah, he did lose his balance, that's all he did, Mark. He slipped, and he slips into Andy Cole. This gives him a little push as well. A little unlucky, but I think it's probably the right decision. Well, if ever's a time to make sure you want the goalkeeper, then this is it.
Identical spot to Beckham's earlier free kick, which went wide of Seaman's right-hand post.
Well, you know the debate. You fancy it, David, are you going to let me hit it? I can imagine Ryan Giggs saying to him. This is it, both chatting.
Get this right and you go to Wembley. Giggs!
Well, that was a good hit. He walked a goalkeeper. And it's right down his throat. See the goal, great angle over here. gets the bend on it. The bend only takes it to the goalkeeper's arms.
Anelka. He got there before Jonsson. Ljungberg getting involved. Need to work it against Philip Neville, who refused to be passed. Cole for York. Does glory beckon here for Dwight York? We go to extra time at Villa Park. Alec Ferguson and Arsene Wenger will have their team talks here. Arsenal survived when Roy Keane put the ball in the net in the first half, a contentious offside decision given against Manchester United, who made the better chances, but it is still 0-0. We'll be back for extra time.
Oh, let's keep it tight.
Gray and Martin Tyler.
Thank you, Richard. Yes, a second helping, an extra helping of your semi-final fare this Sunday lunchtime. Over the 90 minutes after a bright start, Arsenal haven't been at their best. His defence has gone for another 90 minutes without conceding a goal. He'll be challenged here by Cole, and look how quickly they dealt with the danger. Arsenal do when age finally tells on Dixon Winterburn and Adamson Keogh.
What will Arsene Wenger do?
Can't manage another club.
Probably.
Set up the best veterans team in the country, maybe. Here's Anelka. Remember, Arsenal made a substitution just before extra time. Ljungberg for Overmars. Ole Gunnar Solskjaer warmed up more extravagantly than most during the break. Shot by Gary Neville was Bergkamp totally responsible for that. Did he just kick the ground? It can be painful.
It can be, as well as embarrassing.
But Giggs is the highest in the middle. Into the feet of Cole, trying to do the same to Nicky Butt. No penetration for United there. It seems they've been surprisingly lethargic in their attacking movements, Arsenal. Bergkamp. Stam and Jonsson in particular, fought nobly for the Manchester club.
Good options, Alec Ferguson, Martin, if he wants to take a gamble and pinch a goal. Three very forward-thinking players there.
And back got the better of Vieira, who stayed down. And he's still down. York. Dwight York. He's dragged it wide, and now some treatment for Vieira.
Want Patrick Vieira to be down too long, but like one or two Arsenal fans shouting that they maybe should have been played out with the player lying injured. And just gets caught there, you see that, the ankle, the right ankle.
tweak of the ankle, and we'll just see what running Patrick Vieira's got in him. Comes back on rather tentatively. Through a midfield lacking Vieira's presence then.
Well, Mickey Butt's been through twice now, Martin, at the beginning of this extra time period. Vivas or Vieira had tracked him.
Taking two attempts, Manchester United to get past Crystal Palace here at Villa Park in 95 in the semi-final. David Ellery refereed that affair. It's a second bookable offence for Vivas, and Arsenal go down to 10 men, and Arsene Wenger's team, yet again, is going to be short-handed.
Well, I have to say, I was following the ball, Martin. I can only assume by the referee's action there was an elbow here as the ball was played. Well, it looks like the left arm went up into Nicky Butt's face, right in front of the referee.
Well, it's another twist to the drama. It was seen as a second yellow. Could have been a straight red, really, for brandishing the arm like that. So Arsenal's Argentinian is sent off. Manchester United, who have played the more probing football for most of the match, now have an extra man and maybe are going to utilise an extra forward. Steve McLaren, the new assistant manager, replacement for Brian Kidd, giving Solskjaer some instructions.
Well, now's the time to do it, isn't it? You want to commit an extra attacker. And yeah, somebody like Solskjaer. Might not need him, though. Again, Beckham or Giggs. Take your pick.
We had one apiece earlier. Beckham is wide, Giggs on target. It's Beckham here. Would have challenged David Seaman then, but it hit the top of the wall.
That was a good block, Mark. That was a better free kick. Got it up. It was right on target. Tony Adams, big as you like in that wall. No sign of him ducking out of it. Well, we've seen this Arsenal grit, determination, togetherness tested often in the past. This is another big test for it.
Wicked corner by Beckham. Back in by Key. Headed out by Parler, but trying to get it wide to Beckham, couldn't quite do it. Winterburn intercepted, and here's Bergkamp. And the 10 men are on the attack. At least four of them are. Bergkamp trying to go it alone and make light of the man light. Here's York. Appeals for handball. All credit to David Ellery for spotting that infringement by Vivas as the ball rolled away. He didn't avert his gaze. Not too many protests from Arsenal. And they're in an amazingly familiar position, really, given the success that they've had and the quality in their football. 22 red cards in 2.5 years under Arsene Wenger. Beckham. A turnaround that we all know is Arsenal's prime target at the moment. A minute or so before that. That's run beyond the weary Vieira. Cole, after Keane had played a prominent part. Parler. What are his energy levels like? The upstamp was given a sight of the ball. David Ellery looks at his watch, checks with his assistants. York, might be the chance for one last attack in the first period of extra time from Manchester United. Keown went in and defended with great authority. There's the Nigerian Kanu, who really should be away representing his country this weekend. Arsenal managed to retain his services. Carlin.
Now this is what I mean about Manchester United, but being camped, Martin. Now they've committed three or four players forward. Might just give United a chance to pick a space or two.
And right on the stroke of half-time in extra time. Beckham. It's time to dally here for United. Doing though.
Yeah, they just lost the momentum of the attack.
It's good pressure by Arsenal and Keown in particular. Kanu. He didn't have the pace to stretch away, but did have the poise to stay on the ball. Jungberg. Dixon did well to reach it once and twice. Here's Beckham. That's a wonderful tackle. Wonderful defending by Keown.
Yeah, I just showed him a little bit too much. He waited Keown and suddenly he saw it was away from David Beckham.
Keane. Arsenal fans are urging the referee to blow for half-time. Philip Neville. As though they ran out of ideas for a moment, Manchester United. Still no whistle for the turnaround. But Key, Beckham, Adams is there. It is half time. First period of extra time. Notable for Arsenal being reduced to 10 men by David Ellery. Nelson Vivas, a second bookable offence. It was seen as Andy Gray.
Yeah, well, I think the referee does ever so well here. You see Mickey Butt wins the tackle and then he just pops the ball away and looks to run in behind Vivas. The left elbow comes up straight into the United player's face. The referee, unlike you and I, hadn't followed the ball. He watched to see what was happening. I don't think Vivas can have many arguments, Martin.
Minutes to survive, really, that's the way Arsenal would look at it.
Not a lot Arsene Wenger can do, Martin, except trust his side. He knows it'll be 15 minutes of probably constant defending, so he's got to trust these lads, certainly the back four and goalkeeper. Well, they know what it's all about. But this will be a huge test for them in these circumstances. For Alex, he knows, what can I do to win it? What can I do to just get a chink in their armour? To give my, one of my players a chance to, for a bit of glory to take us through the final. That's what he's thinking.
Well, if you scored it on points, if you like, Manchester United would be well, well ahead. If you score it on players on the pitch, Manchester United are ahead. But that matters. It remains 0-0 with 15 minutes to go. We play next Wednesday if it stays that way. Staged here. Kanu. Arsenal thinking a bit more than just survival with Ray Parlour. Vieira. Well, by Solskjaer. Arsenal be in no hurry to restart the game. Any extra seconds that they can salvage. Gratefully received. Parlour. Stamp, Bergkamp interested, his technique is not particularly good in those circumstances, and he's given away a foul himself.
I wouldn't give that linesman too much stick, Dennis. He didn't do your half do your favour first half.
Well, that remains the major talking point from the match to this point. Scholes. Frightened of barreling into Adams either.
Beckham. Almost pulled that ball down. He got away with the contact. It ran away from him. A few more seconds passed, though. Arsenal will be all the happier with the draw if that's the way it finishes, and a chance to play better, and they can play a lot better than this in a replay on Wednesday.
Yeah, I think Arsene Wenger will be absolutely delighted the way this second half of extra time has panned out, Martin. I thought they would be under real pressure. They were camped first part period, but they've managed to get possession of the ball at times and keep United pretty much at arm's length for much of it.
That's a lovely ball reversed by Butt to Keane. Waits for Philip Neville. Arsenal draw up their battle lines on the edge of the area again. Solskjaer. So many potential match winners here. Manchester United.
And that was a bad ball from Solskjaer. He really gave Gary Neville a problem, and that's dissent shown.
Gary Neville reacted angrily then. Booked right at the start.
I tell you, I think discretion there. I have to say, Martin, it was an act of dissent, slamming the ball into the ground. He's getting away with this.
Was it an act of dissent at a teammate?
Define it.
Bergkamp. Ljungberg darting through. Frederik Ljungberg! Schmeichel, by far the most difficult moment he's had in the match, and it's come right at the end of the match.
That's a great save, but I think Ljungberg's touching it cost him a chance. I thought the quality of the pass made it that he didn't need to take anything other than just finish it. There was no need to control it for me. It's a brilliant run from Ljungberg and a superb pass, but it's there he hits it. The touch just gets him too close to the goalkeeper. And there's no need. It's played in. Right foot just over him, around him, but you see how close that touch took him to the goalkeeper.
It was Bergkamp's best moment of the match as well. The pass might be better here now he's given offside.
Well, rather belatedly given offside, that's... Flag took an eternity to go up. Well, it looked offside to me, you can see he is, but the flag's not up, then it goes.
Come down to Beckham, York!
Well, both could have won the match.
You took the words from my mouth.
Within 30 seconds, we've had two of the best chances of the match. Adams comes and gets involved with Winterburn, perhaps he shouldn't have done. It's a snap chance for Dwight York, it's a little angle. David Seaman did well to get pretty close to him again and make it awkward. It's Ljungberg and York within a matter of 30 seconds, could have won the match for their teams.
Kicked off Bergkamp, Johnson got a bang in the face. Here comes Roy Parlour.
Oh,
Kanu calling for the cross. He was unmarked because Johnson had just lost his concentration for a moment. He's got it back now, although the ball rather bounced off his knees. Still a bit shaken up, Ronnie Johnson. Dixon. Vieira. Dixon's ball forward. Bergkamp and Stam. It's a tussle that the referee decides to say. Six of one, half a dozen of the other. We're in the dying embers of this semi-final at Villa Park. Scholes just drifting away to be able to make the header. Cleared by Keogh, for the umpteenth time. Here's Scholes again. York, Solskjaer, but it's Dixon. They shut the door again. That Arsenal back line. Vieira. It's time added on at the end of extra time here. Kanu. Oh, Bergkamp! Dennis Bergkamp! It was Gary Neville who rescued Manchester United. A thrilling finale. Arsenal with 10 men twice now
in the last couple of minutes, getting into a position where winning the game was on. Could it be a third time? It's full time. We come back to Villa Park on Wednesday. Bergkamp suddenly switched on in the last few minutes of extra time and nearly took himself to an FA Cup final. Ljungberg, from Bergkamp's pass, had the chance to win the game for 10 men. Arsenal, Vivas sent off in extra time. Dwight York also came very close near the end. Manchester United will still reflect on Roy Keane's disallowed goal. Keane, your choice as man of the match.
Arsene, was that a case of your defence keeping you in the FA Cup?
Yes, because in the first half we had a difficult first half. Manchester was sharp on top of the game, and we needed time to come back into it, and slowly we came back into it in the second half, and after we created chances as well. But we need a great experience and great spirit again, resilience, because down to 10 men again, it was very difficult against a team like Man United, but we have had a tremendous spirit today again.